Hello, Keith Rucker at VintageMachinery.org. Well, I got myself in a little bit of jam here. Maybe not so bad, but something we need to take some time and work on. So yesterday, I moved my milling machines into my shop here at home. And in the process of moving them, one thing I like to do is I like to rotate this head down when I'm moving it, just so that I lower my center of gravity. I don't have my center of gravity way up high when I'm moving. I drop my tables all the way down. I push my tables all the way back, and I like to roll that head around, make this machine as compact as it can when I'm picking it up with a forklift, when I'm slinging it with a overhead crane or whatever to move them around. That's just the way I like doing it. So we drop this head down, and in the process of doing so, and I'm not exactly sure how this happened, but back here on the back, you see I got this little ratchet right here. There's a worm gear that goes in here that engages this head, and you can actually turn it all the way down. When I got it almost all the way down to the bottom where I wanted, and I've had it there before, all of a sudden the worm quit adjusting. And when I got ready to pull it back up, I realized, and what I think has happened is right here, this piece that goes in here goes into a worm gear. It's got a keyway in that worm gear, and this piece had slid back and the key was no longer engaging the worm. So the worm was, when I cranked this on this gear, on this right here, I can see the worm gear is not turning, hence I don't have that mechanical advantage to help me pull that head back around. So project for the day is I've tried to get this thing in the right position and tap that back in place and hoping that the key would go back into the gear. It's just not working out. So we're gonna pull the head off of this so that I can really get in there and see what's going on, see if there's any damage, and see about doing a repair to get this fixed. Hopefully it's gonna be nothing more than just putting it back together and whatever we need to do to keep that shaft from pulling back out again. I've got a parts diagram, so I have an idea of how this works, although it's not super detailed, so I can't really see every detail. But we're gonna pull the head off and try to take care of this little problem. All right, guys, we got this rigged up with some slings. I'm using my engine hoist here as a kind of a crane to help me hold this thing up. And there are four bolts that basically just go through here that this rotates on, and my plan is that we should be able to take these four bolts out and the whole head should slide out, and we can take the head off and set it down over here on the table behind me. So I'm gonna go ahead and pull these bolts and get them ready where this will hopefully just come off. Loosen this other one. This one is the one that's holding it up right now. So that's dropping down. And my slings have caught it, I believe. All right, we've got things pretty well supported here. See what we got to do to get it to come out now. All right, guys, progress. This has been a challenging work in progress so far, trying to figure out how to get this thing out. So I took the four bolts off and tried to slide it out, and it wouldn't come. And I got to looking, and that worm gear was basically right behind this. So this went through here. The worm was on this shaft, and that engages with the actual gear up in here. That spins the head around. Well, I was finally, to get this out, basically I had to get the worm out so that it would slide out because it was captured in there. And here's the problem. Here's my shaft, and I'll get a close-up of this, but the key in here just has become sheared off, and it's all boogered up in there anyway. That's the problem. I was able to get that out. The key, the worm dropped out the bottom, and now the head's pulling out. So we're gonna go ahead and finish pulling the head out. And I think there's also some damage to the gear up in here, which is maybe part of the problem. So we'll know better once we get it out. Let's see if we can finagle this thing out. All right, we're out, and I'm gonna go get a place to set this down. Very good. I'm gonna take these off. So this worm gear is on here with two roll pins that actually go all the way through. So I've got my punch lined up here and I should be punching out a roll pin here. There's another one on the inside. There's one. There's the roll pin. Across in front of the camera and should have the same thing over here. There we go. Now we've got to get that out. That's going to be the fun part. Let's see if, no, it's going to spin. Maybe it won't be as bad as I think. There it comes. Okay. That wasn't near as bad, but I'll zoom you in here and show you the problem. So as you can see, we got some teeth that are just tore out of this thing. Man, this sucks. I guess I'm gonna get on the phone Monday, call Wells Index and see how many thousands of dollars they want for this part. But at least I know what we got to do. Quick update here. I pulled the Woodruff key out and you can see on there that piece is actually cracked. You see it right here? So, wow, there was some stress put on this thing at one point in time. I'm not sure that. Again, I kind of feel like, because when we were moving this thing down, I never really got this in a bind. It just kind of got to a point and all of a sudden it just started slipping. I think the damage was already done. And I when I was adjusting it around, it might have been the straw that broke the camel's back. I think I got over into this area here where some the teeth were out of it and it probably bound up a little bit, but I think that this was actually already done, but it was just enough that it just sheared off the last little bit holding that keyway, that key in. Regardless, it's a problem. Again, I'm not sure if I caused this or whether this was pre-existing. I think the latter, but we got to deal with it either way. So this part, that's easy enough. I can make that on the lathe. The gear, looking at it, it's kind of rough. I've got a part number. This is a Boston Gear part number. I'm going to look this worm gear up. If that's something I can order stock, I may just go ahead and get one. Now, and that leaves this, the big part here, the actual part that has the broken teeth in it that we got to deal with. But I think I've even got an idea of what we can do about that. So I've got a little small section in here where the teeth are broken out of the gear. You can kind of see them there. But looking at this, even though the gear teeth are all the way around this ring, on the mill, it's impossible to turn the head 360 degrees. You can really only turn it about 180 degrees. You know, from horizontal to horizontal there. So a lot of these teeth would never really be used. So I think what I can actually do is, you know, currently, in fact, you can kind of see there's an area right here in the top that is totally unworn. I count them, there's 11 teeth there that don't even have grease in them. And what I'm thinking about doing is just rotating this so that my bad teeth are at the top in that zone that's not being utilized, and the rest of the teeth are fine. What that would require is positioning this so and getting some new holes drilled in the proper place, which would basically be straight up and down all the way through this. And I think I can salvage this part right here by just repositioning it. So anyway, we got some projects ahead of us. The real fun part is making this shaft is not a problem. I can do it all on the lathe, except for the Woodruff key. So I don't know, I might have to do that on my horizontal mill, which is completely doable to get by. So anyway, we got a little project here ahead of us, and I'm gonna need to probably jump on this pretty soon, just simply from the standpoint that I need to get this mill back up and running. So anyway, there you go. So a quick update here on what we're working on. It's actually been a few days since we took this mill apart. I have ordered a few parts in, got some materials in to start my repair job. And the first thing we're gonna work on is this shaft. And as I pointed out before, you know, this piece right here has seen some abuse. This end down here is supposed to be 5/8 inch hex. It's been kind of gnarled up over the years. Looks like someone's been using crescent wrench or something like that, pliers, who knows, but it's not in good shape. But the most concerning thing is right here with the keyway, is you can see this little tear out in here. And I think this is where this shaft had come partially out. And you can kind of see a wear mark right in here. And anyway, got a bunch of force on there, and it literally tore the steel back here where the key is. So we're gonna make a new one of these. I ordered some 5/8 inch hex material. This is actually 4140 steel. This is what some people call chrome moly, which is a good durable material, and I think would serve us well in this particular part. So we're gonna go ahead and on the LeBlanc lathe, this will actually be the first real job that I've ever done on this lathe since we've restored it. So we're looking forward, we're gonna make this right here. We'll have to go cut that Woodruff key slot there on the horizontal mill. I'll also mention that on this is where this worm actually fits onto, and of course with the damage down there, it won't go all the way up on. But the original worm, it's got some really rough spots in it. And anyway, I've got a new worm for this, and I was able to look the part number up actually in my Wells Index manual and parts catalog that I have for the milling machine. It listed the parts number, and this is a Boston Gear parts number. What is that? L1056. So anyway, I went online, searched it, and lo and behold, right there in Amazon.com, Boston Gear L1056 pulls right up. I think this was like $37-$38, something like that. So I just went ahead and ordered a brand new one. So we're gonna be replacing this old one with a new one while we're in there. Anyway, let's get started, and let's see if we can crank this part out on the LeBlanc lathe. All right, here we go. First thing I'm gonna do is we're gonna come in here and just make a little witness mark on this shaft down here for as deep as it needs to go. And this isn't a super critical measurement. It's gonna be about right there. And so I'm just gonna come in here and make a mark, and that will give me something to turn to. All right, we got our witness mark here. We're just gonna go ahead and turn this down. So let me come back in here. We'll touch off. And that's about 2040. We'll start off with a 60 thousandths cut. are 30 thousandths cut, 60 thousandths total. And let's let her rip. We're basically just taking those hex corners off, and the nominal size of the is 5/8, and we're but we're taking down to a 5/8 diameter. So basically just taking all the square sides off of this. Just simply because I'm not used to this lathe yet, and I don't want to go too far. So, let's measure across here and see where we're at. So we're at about 664, three, something like that. We want to go 625, so we got 10, 20, about 30 thousandths to go. So I'm gonna sneak up on it. We'll make a 20 thousandths pass here, see where we're at. 20 thousandths total. About a 10 thousandths cut, 20 thousandths total. About 16 thousandths more to go. So I'm gonna try to dial in to just within pretty close to it. So I'm taking about a 14 thousandths total here, about half of that actual cut. And let's see where we're at. Pretty close there. Yeah, that looks good. So we're just under 625. Should be good enough. So let's go from here. And so we're looking at kind of like this. So next thing we're gonna do is turn down this part down here. This is the part that the worm will actually go up on. That diameter is a half inch, a little under a half inch. The total length on that is about 935. Put me a little mark on there. Come in here and make that where I can see it a little bit better. Cut that on down. Inch. Let me get my worm gear, worm, and see if that'll fit up on there. The original shaft I have is a couple thousandths under a half inch, and it looks like we're going to need to do the same thing here. we're real close. So I'm just going to take a really light pass here. In fact, I think what I'm going to do is start off with just a spring pass. That fits real nice, so go with that. All right, so the final step here, so we need to cut this little slot in here, and basically what this is for a set screw to go down into, and it keeps this part from coming in and out. That's part of the problem that I had, is that it didn't have the right kind of set screw in there. It wasn't properly seated in this, and I think over time this part had started walking back, which is why we had only a partial key in there, which I think is what caused this thing to strip out. So anyway, we're going to go ahead and cut that. I've just got a little hand ground parting tool in here that we're going to use for that. Just out of some high speed steel, nothing fancy. And I'm going to have to do it in two passes because this isn't going to be wide enough. And basically we're just going down to a half inch depth. I've already got this shoulder set to the proper distance from the end. And this depth is not critical. It's just clearance for that cutter or for that set screw to go in there and keep that part from coming out. So I'm just feeding this in by hand. I'm just eyeballing that depth right now. Let's see where we're at. Again, this depth is not critical. That bottom's not actually flat with this cutter either. But again, main thing I need is just clearance in there. And right on half inch. That ain't bad for eyeballing. So let me get a measure to the outside. I'm just gonna scoot this over here. Just measure this. Again, this is not super critical on this width. This should get me pretty darn close. Let me come in here a little bit closer. That should be right on. So I'm just gonna go that same depth or close to it. Suffice for what we're after. All right, we've got our lathe work done. I'm gonna go ahead, we'll pull this out. I'm gonna cut that to length. I think I will come in here and put some chamfers on here. I'll probably just do that off camera just to break those edges. We'll cut this to length and then we'll be ready to go to the milling machine and cut a keyway. Well, let's see how we did here. I've got the part, we went ahead and cut it off. I faced the end and just kind of chamfered that in to get a nice smooth surface there. I want to make sure everything fits. So this half inch, the worm of course fits up on here and then this goes into a hole behind it and you got 5/8 on this side and it goes in just fine. So everything looks good there. Let's try it with the actual worm in here. Here's the worm. I'm going to slide it up in here. It fits just right. And again, put it all together. And that's exactly what we want. Looks like we got a good fit. So the final thing is here on this is we need to cut our Woodruff key slot in here. Well guys, I've hit a little roadblock. I wasn't expecting this. I've got a really nice selection of Woodruff key cutters. As you can see, I got them all organized here. And what we need is, this is an 1/8 inch slot and it's about a 3/4 inch keyway diameter. I've looked up in my machinery's handbook and an 1/8 inch by 3/4 is a number 406. I go up to a number 405, and which is what, by 1/2 inch, I guess. Anyway, it's a 1/2 inch diameter. I need a 3/4 inch diameter. So, I got to order a Woodruff key cutter. I should have a key. I need to double check that. I got an assortment of keys as well, but I'll double check that, make sure I have one of those as well. But we've hit a roadblock for now. I'm probably just going to have to stop this video here. I had planned on getting all this done before we got through, but I'm running against the clock. I need to get this video pushed out to you guys. So we're going to stop here. Well, we'll get those parts ordered, and in the next episode on this fix, we'll get this part finished and get it installed. And also, we've still got to work on the actual worm gear here. As we mentioned before, we've got some broken teeth here. Not good, but fortunately, I can just reposition these teeth because they're not all used, and that's going to require us setting this up on the milling machine. Probably going to put in the dividing head and come in here and get lined up on these holes. These holes are pretty critical, being exactly in the center and being in the right distance from the end. And then what I'll do is we'll rotate this around to the correct position, drill the new holes, and then I'll use my dividing head to flip it over exactly 180 degrees and do the other side, assuming I can get this in the chuck on my dividing head. That's plan A. We'll see what happens. But that's the plan for next part of this. I'm anxious to get this mill going, so we're going to get these parts ordered. I'm shooting this on a Wednesday. I need to get my video pushed out on Friday morning, and if I order them, well, I won't be able to order them till tomorrow because McMaster, it's already too late in the evening to order it tonight, so I order it tomorrow. It'll be here Friday, and hopefully over the weekend we'll get this finished up for you guys. So anyway, thanks for watching, and hopefully we'll have the Wells Index back up and going in the next edition of this video. Thanks a lot.